What's up guys, how are you? As you can see from the title of this video, this is a video for any of you who feels insecure because maybe you are losing your hair recently or you've lost it in the past and you are still feeling a tad of insecurity or very, very insecure as a consequence. And what I'm about to do is tell you two simple things that will eliminate completely this insecurity and will increase your chances and will help you to attract girls in your life. Before I tell them, I want to tell you first that I know exactly where you're at. Basically, because I've also been in the exact same spot. I lost my hair when I was 22. And I went through the same phase of not accepting it, of feeling very insecure, of wearing hats, kept covering it up, or to hold on to the few little hairs that I still had on the top and all that. And I know how painful it is. I know exactly how it feels, how hopeless it can feel, how it may seem that maybe your dating life is dead. And I feel you. I feel you, my man. But no, that it is not going to be like that if you do what I'm about to tell you. I'm also not going to spread lies, and I'm also going to share some uncomfortable truths about the reality of being a bald man. I think there's a lot of lies that tend to be said by all these pickup gurus and dating gurus and whatnot, saying that the physical beauty doesn't matter, that your money and status doesn't matter. No, I don't think like that. I actually think that physical appearance is very, very important for girls in the same way that it is for us guys. Like, the girls that you like, the girls that you tend to like, tend to have a pleasing physical appearance that attracts you. And therefore, girls also want to have the same, obviously. And okay, so that is the first thing. So first uncomfortable truth: you losing your hair means that for 98% or 95% of guys, it means that you have decreased slightly, or you've decreased a few points in the physical beauty department. Therefore, what you need to focus on is on actions that will increase your attractiveness, okay? Your first impression attractiveness. And you do that by doing these two simple things. Be a man that on his free time focuses on this. One, you are a man that hits the gym with frequency, meaning 5-6 times per week. Okay, and two, you are a man that focuses his time, his free time, in building a business, a project that has the chance to increase his own income. So apart from your job, you're always working on something that has the possibility to bring in more income and therefore increase your financial status. Okay, so these are the two things. If you are a man, for example, who works out 5-6 times per week, eventually in 6 months, 1 year, and I cannot even tell you in 2, 3, 4, 5 years, you will develop a rocking body that will increase, without a doubt, your attractiveness as a man. Think about of a girl in your life or in your past who was not very, like, physically attractive. She didn't have a very, very beautiful face. Maybe she was even a little bit weird in the face, but she had a rocking body. And not only that, she dressed incredibly well. Well, that is exactly the same strategy that can be applied to yourself. Even though you may have lost a few points by losing your hair, you can increase your points by developing a rocking body. That means a body that when you get yourself naked in the shower and look at yourself in the mirror, you really like yourself. Like you actually feel proud and you say, man, I look good. I feel great with how I look. That is the state, the emotion that you want to create, and you will undoubtedly create that emotion by being a man that has a habit of hitting the gym 5-6 times per week. If for whatever reason you don't have the money to or you don't want to invest in hitting the gym, maybe work out at home or do some calisthenics or whatever floats your boat, but whatever sort of sport that does have an impact of increasing your muscle mass and make you look very attractive. And the second one, as I said, is always be working on a project that has the chance to increase your income by a few, as much as you can, obviously. That will help you to become a man that has a higher financial status, and money is something that attracts us all. And with girls, it is also the same, even though it is something sort of a bit of a taboo sort of subject. It is undoubtedly true that we tend to feel a sort of drawn to people who have more financial success than us. We perceive them as more valuable, even though it doesn't necessarily need to be so. You could be a very shitty person with a lot of money, but it is undoubtedly true that society tends to perceive people who have a higher financial status as more valuable, more, and therefore in the dating department also more attractive. So if you are always a man that on his free time is working on one project that has the chance to increase your financial status, your income, what will happen is that eventually you will hit a home run. Eventually you will land on a project that is responding in the market and is actually selling very, very well. And that will bring a flood of money to your life that will allow you to increase your attractiveness even more. For example, that is money that you can use to maybe do a hair transplant and have, again, a head full of hair, which will increase your attractiveness. You can also use that money to hire a nutrition coach and a fitness coach that will put that will make you look absolutely incredible. You can also use that money to buy nicer clothes. It is not the same to wear some Zara jacket and some H&M t-shirt and, you know, and very cheap sort of clothes than to wear good brands that look insane on you. It is not the same to wear a Zara leather jacket than to be rocking a Saint Laurent leather jacket. It is just not the same. You will look remarkably well with clothes that tend to be a bit expensive for the average man. So those are the two things that I think that you can apply like today and will drastically increase your attractiveness as a man. Before I close this video, I want to say that if you don't have the habit of going to the gym often, don't be brutal with it. Don't start out going 5-6 times per week, okay? Because you will not be able to build the habit and you will not be able to sustain the habit long term, which is what you want. Therefore, what you want to apply is the right amount of effort. And the right amount of effort is always slightly above of what is comfortable for you, okay? And I always explain this with the analogy of picking up a weight. If your biceps feels very, very comfortable doing 8 repetitions with, say, 10 kilos, okay? And you can do 8 sets with 10 kilos without a problem, and it just doesn't cost you very much. That is not the right amount of effort. If, on the other hand, you grab a 30 kilo dumbbell and you cannot even barely get to 8, and you cannot do more than maybe 2 or 3 sets, that is also not the right amount of effort. But if you grab a weight that is 15, for example, and you notice that on the 7th or 8th repetition you start to struggle, but you are able to do 8 sets and actually work the muscle, that is the right amount of effort. So the same goes with these two habits that I shared with you. If you've never gone to the gym, don't start out going 5-6 times per week. Start out small, okay? Until maybe go 1 or 2 times per week, until that amount of effort is comfortable for you. Once it's comfortable for you, increase that effort slightly. Put 1 day extra and the same until it feels comfortable, and then you increase, bum, 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 like that. Eventually, you'll be able to be the man that is able to go 5-6 times per week to the gym without a problem. And it is a habit that will stay for you forever, forever. You will not struggle with, oh, I need to go to the gym. No, it will come naturally to you. And the same with working on a project that has the ability to increase your financial status, your income. If you are not a man who is used to use his own free time to work on extra stuff, okay, you've been, I don't know, maybe chilling and stuff, don't start out putting in 4, 5, 6 hours every day after work. No, start out small. What do you feel comfortable with? Maybe 30 minutes every afternoon. Okay, 30 minutes. It may not be enough at the beginning, but it's better that you start out small and you build on that gradually. Eventually, you'll be able to increase that effort. Bam, 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 bam. And eventually, you'll be able to be a man that works on his own project and goes to the gym often without much of an effort, and that will literally mean that you've built the habit successfully. Remember, it is always better to do a little bit every day than to do a lot and do it irregularly. And when I say that you want to sustain stuff over the long term, I mean years, not a few months. I mean 1, 5, 10 years. So that was the video of today. Hope you liked it. Hit the like button if you liked it. And if you didn't like it, don't hit the dislike button. Okay. Hit the dislike button. Okay, no worries. See you in the next one.